Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back for another TOS video. So it's been a while since I posted some legit videos on my channel, right? So I just came back from Japan and I decided to take a few days of break before I actually start, you know, kicking out new contents once again, right? So I'm officially back, so you'll be expecting more TOS contents from now onwards, right? So in this card review, we're gonna talk about the brand new 5-star Chinese mythological beast power release form, right? So yes, they have been through power release already. So I think this news came out a bit too it came out a few days back, right? So it's gonna be a bit old news for you guys, right? But I'm gonna still do a whole review about this entire series, right? Is it worth it or not, right? So new power release form, which means that it's gonna get like a branch evolution, same as the cyborg scholars, right? So we have the human race evolution pathway and the machina evolution pathway, right? So let's take a look at what this Chinese beast is going to offer, right, in their machina form. Alright, so as usual, I'm just gonna go down the attributes, right? Starting from water attribute, we have Qinglong here, which is water machina now, right? Very, very nice artwork there. So when the team consists of only machina and dragons, right? So I think previously it's just dragons, right? So now they kind of include the machina playstyle. Right, so attack times 4.5 and attack plus 300, right? So I believe this 300 applies to all members in the team. By dissolving a group of 3 or more runestones in the column below a machina, the monster's attack times 1.5 times additionally, right? So this is somewhat similar to what we have for the primal Greek gods, Fanes, as well as Gaia, right? When you dissolve the column below, you know, the monster, they kind of have some additional multiplier to them. Right, so overall, I find that this is going to be quite strong, right? But I won't say super strong, right? They kind of just bring them back into the meta for a bit, right? So of course, not going to be that powerful, but I guess it's going to be quite a good team member for upcoming machina race and stuff like that, right? So notice that Madhead is trying to give players more variety of machinas now, since it is a relatively new race, right? So the card pool is still very, very limited for machinas, right? So Qinglong here is going to be pretty good as a member, right? So let's take a look at his active skill. Right, so what you can see here is Qinglong's active skill at CD5, no change, right? Back then it was CD5, now it's CD5 as well. Turn the columns of runestones below two machinas into enchanted water runestones, right? So I believe if there is more than, you know, if you are running like a full machina team, I believe it's going to be randomly converted, right? They didn't say which column. Right, so I believe it's randomly selected. Right, if leader allies are machina, leader and ally attack times 2.5 for one round. Right, so I believe this kind of convert slash boosters, right, is mainly for like a mono water team setup. Right, so the only water machina leader for now is probably Mobius, right? But I'm not really a big fan of Mobius, as you guys know. Right, so maybe in the future, there'll be more meta water machina team, right? So anyways, right, Qinglong here kind of is quite, in terms of active skill, it is very good, right? Just that we do not have a suitable leader to kind of use Qinglong in, right? So I believe this card here is going to be quite useful in upcoming, you know, patches when they drop a proper water machina leader, right? Especially CD5, you get a leader ally boost for one round, right? 2.5 multiplier for CD5 is actually pretty good, right? Plus you have two columns of convert, right, which give you some sustainable damage there. Right, so with that, let's move on to the next card. Right, the next card I'm going to talk about will be Zhu Cue. Right, so we're going to go from the leader skill to the active skill as usual. Right, so leader skill, we have machina playstyle and beast playstyle recovery times 3. Right, so notice there is no attack multiplier whatsoever, right? Very similar to what we have for the beast version of Zhu Cue. Right, by dissolving hard runes, HP as much as 5% of total machina and beast recovery will be recovered. So that's actually pretty good, right? So back then, right, when we were playing like Nihok, right, the seal, I think it was the fifth seal, right? Zhu Cue was quite meta back then, right, for the overheal part, right? So for a leader skill which have no attack multiplier whatsoever, I don't think we're gonna actually use this card here as a leader whatsoever, right? So let's take a look at his active skill, Phoenix from the Ashes. So HP will be depleted to 1 for one round if a group of 5 or more runestones are dissolved in a column 4 enchanted fire will be generated, right? It's like a one round of fire Babylonian. If a group of 5 or more runestones are dissolved in 2 or more columns, HP will be fully recovered, right? So I believe this is kind of like the third Machina card that we have that actually depletes HP to 1. Right, so first we have Shenozer from the Mechanical Life series, the Dark card. Right, next we have Delta from the Biweekly series, which actually depletes your HP to 1 as well. And after that, adds on the depleted HP to its attack. Right, so that's kind of like a Delta is more of a defense breaker kind of card. Right, but if you want like one turn of massive sky drop, right, Zhuchue is the way to go. Right, so I believe Zhuchue can be actually paired with Epsilon. Right, so Epsilon, if your HP is 1, it converts the entire board to fire heart columns, and that actually gives you a perfect board to actually trigger this entire 4 enchanted fire rune sky drop there. Right, so Zhuchue and Epsilon is going to be pretty good as a pair. Right, so you can actually put it in a Pompeii team, so that will work out quite good as well. Right, so we'll see how it goes. Right, this patch is going to drop on Monday. Right, so we're going to test it out. Right, so let's move on to the next card. Okay, next card is gonna be the Mac Emerald Tortoise Xuan Wu. Right, so let's take a look at its leader skill as well. So Machina and Beast HP times 3. So same as Zhuchue, there is no attack multiplier here for the leader skill. So upon receiving damage from the enemy's attack, deal non-attribute damage as much as 5 times the total Machina and Beast HP to all enemies before attacking in the next round. Right, so overall I find that in order We kind of have like a similar thing, right? It's just that it is in a form of active skill, which is Earth Lino. Right, so Earth Lino is definitely better, right? In order to deal this non-attributive damage, it's actually good in removing invisibility shield and stuff like that. Right, but the only thing is Xuan Wu doesn't have an attack multiplier for his leader skill, so in order quite useless in terms of leader skill, right, in my opinion. Right, so let's take a look at his active skill. Sylvan Spirits. Turn 5 runestones into enchanted heart, dark and light, rank first in priority. Heart runes possess 50% effect of earth for 1 round. The effect plus 50% for every extra earth machina present in the team to the max, 300%. Right, so we have kind of like a rose gameplay here. Right, rose leader skill actually gives additional boost for, I mean, it's heart. Heart runes actually possess more than 100% effect, right? So Xuan Wu here is going to give you 1 turn of that and to the max 300% effect for every heart runes. Right, so in my opinion, I find that this is going to be quite good, right? Xuan Wu is going to be quite useful, right, in a tiering, if you guys remember tiering, right, from Crash Fever collaboration. Tiering as well as Li Tie Guai from the 8CN series, right? So these few cards are actually not really prioritizing light and dark in terms of their attacking runes, right? So Xuan Wu's active skill here is going to fit in perfectly for these two gameplay, right? So I can't wait to test this out as well, right? 300% for heart runes for 1 turn is actually pretty good, right? Kind of reminds me of Kagura from King of Fighters, right? The one that converts heart as well. I'm not sure if I remember the name correctly, but it was the Coliseum card for King of Fighters. Right, so without further ado, let's move on to the light and dark mechanical beast. Okay, so here we have Bai Hu and Tao Tie, right? So they're pretty much having the same leader skill, which is why they are both at the same page, right? So let's take a look at his leader skill at first. So leader skill, we have team consists of only Machina and Beast, team attack times 5, right? 5 isn't that strong in my opinion, right? So leader's attribute possess 50% effect of other attributive runestones, and it can be superimposed, right? So I believe they kind of want you to use like a Bai Hu ally Tao Tie or Tao Tie ally Bai Hu kind of playstyle, right? So light and dark actually possess, you know, whatever attribute that you bring in, right, for the team, right? So this allows you to bring a rainbow setup and still allows, you know, all the team members to attack within 1 turn, right, more efficiently. And on top of that, when 5 or more combos are made, fuels on Machina plus 5%. When all Machinas in the team have 100% fuel, the monster attack times 2. Right, so I believe this times 2 is going to stack on top of the team attack times 5 for the leader skill. Right, so that actually gives a decent amount of multiplier. Right, but the problem of this team is we don't really have much utilities. Right, so unless Madhead kind of release more Machinas or more, you know, possible beast cards, right, to add on to this Baihu and Tao Tie, right, this team would be pretty good as a, you know, as a proper team setup. Right, so 5 or more combos made fuel of Machinas plus 5%, this pretty much assists, you know, in a rainbow kind of Machina setup, right, we kind of run into a situation whereby one attribute is already at 100% fuel and then the other one is like what, at 70-80%, right, kind of piss you off, right, so this definitely allows Machina to charge up faster, right, so let's take a look at Baihu and Tao Tie's active skill. Right, so what you can see here is Baihu's active skill, right, this is going to be one of my favorite active skill within the series, right, Lightning Strikes, CD6, right, CD6 is definitely a big improvement from its beast counterpart, right, the beast counterpart for its, you know, for its CD is super long, right, even with the amelioration and stuff like that. Right, so CD6 for one round, beast and Machina attack times 1.5, ignores enemy defense by 80%. If monster's fuel is 100% upon activation, the attack multiplier increases to times 2, right, instead of 1.5, and damage will be dealt regardless of defense. Right, so this is going to be quite situational, right? In order to have 100% fuel means that you must have at least 2 Machinas in your team. Right, so if you're going to run like a mono-like setup, you must have at least 2 light Machina team, Machina cards in your team, right, in order to activate this fuel system, and then with that, then you can activate this times 2 multiplier as well as 100% defense ignore, right, ignore defense by 100%. Right, so overall this is going to be a good improvement from the beast version of this Baihu. Right, so back then I think it was 95% or 90% defense ignore, right, but now we have 100% ignore just like Wukong and other, you know, other cards like Firekeeper and stuff like that, right, which is definitely useful, right, considering now when Madhead released a high defense monster, the defense is usually very very high, and then minus 90% defense is still pretty tanky, right, in terms of their defense, right, so grats Baihu back into the meta. Okay, and to end off the video, we have Tao Tie's active skill, Darkness of Devourer, CD6, right, so we have an increase in CD from CD5 to CD6, right, but we have a better active skill, right, in order, for now, CD5, we have a hard to, light to hard convert, right, so now we have CD6, light and hard into enchant hard, and on top of that, we have an offensive convert as well from water and dark into enchanted dark, right, which is always a good thing. Right, so if HP is 1 upon skill activation, the monster attack base value plus 2000 for one round. Right, so that is actually pretty high. Right, so as you can see, HP is 1, right, kind of, they kind of want you to pair it with Zhuchue, I guess. Right, but don't forget, Zhuchue is not the only card that actually brings your HP to 1. Right, we have Delta, we have Schnauzer. Right, so I believe it can be paired with Schnauzer because it is dark attribute. Right, and then it kind of runs with the same, and you can pair Tao Tie and Schnauzer for 2 Machinas to enable the fuel system. And of course, we can not forgetting we have Odin as well, right, if you want to have a bulk HP, right, so Odin can actually, you know, drain your HP to 1, and then after that you can use Tao Tie as well, right, so many different combinations, right, so depends on how you're gonna play Tao Tie. Right, I believe this card here can be very good in, you know, breaking defense and stuff like that as well. Right, so can't wait to actually test this card in future battles. Right, so overall I feel that the best improvement, right, will be Tao Tie as well, followed by Baihu. I can kind of rank both at the same, right, Tao Tie and Baihu, and then after that Xuan Wu will be good as well, right, which is the Earth one, right, good for the Tie Guai as well as Turing, as I mentioned earlier, right, followed by Zhuchue and then Qinglong. Right, so Qinglong, I won't say Qinglong is bad, but it just doesn't have the best or the right water Machina leader to pair it with for now. Alright, so overall this is going to be card review for the 5 mechanical beasts, right, Chinese mythological Beast Machina Form Evolution. Alright, so if you like this video, of course, do give it a like, and then as usual, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye bye.